Now, part of the design calls for a piped off piece, which in this design is actually a heart made of raw icing. What I've done is I've drawn around a heart-shaped cutter. This one I've actually laminated, only because I use it a lot, but it could just be a piece of card, to be honest with you. I'm gonna stick it to my board, just with a few dabs of raw icing. This is so that I can move the board around without dislodging my template. This is a piece of wax paper. It could be cellophane, although I do find wax paper works easier because it's not as flexible. A couple of dots of raw icing down, just to hold it in place. I don't want to stick it down with tape or something, because in a few seconds I'm going to be lifting it off the board. Now, in here I've got raw icing. This is a number 44. This is a PME nozzle, although I believe the nearest equivalent is a 362 in a Wilton. It's a small star nozzle. So starting at the top of the heart, I'm going to pipe over the top of the heart there, all the way down to the peak. When I get down to the peak, I'm going to stop squeezing and finish off my line. If I've overshot the line slightly, I will use a small paintbrush just to tidy it up. Now, turn it around the other way. It will make it easier for me to pipe the other direction. Starting so it's touching there, pipe the other line all the way around, come back down, touch it off there. It's very important that you take a damp paintbrush and just make sure all of those joins are nice and secure, because of course this will be coming off your paper later. Now, while you have this in this position, take a number 2 nozzle, that's a PME number 2, it's also a Wilton number 2, and overpipe a thinner line. This will just give your heart a bit more definition. Now, if you did want to add more colour to this design, or use this technique for another cake, say, you could add colour at this point to that line. So again, turning it around, because it's easier if you're right-handed, pipe left to right. If you're left-handed, you can pipe left to right. Sorry, right to left, so you can pipe it in the opposite direction. So here you go, just put that line on there one more time. Just pipe it over the top. As I said, this just accents your heart shape and gives a bit of finish. Now, once that's actually been piped, before it dries or crusts, I will take it off its template. I will then take one of these, it's a former. This could be a cardboard roll, it could be a part of drain pipe, as long as it's food safe. I then take my heart and I will lay it over the top to dry. Now, when I do these for cakes, I would actually do several of them in one go and then put them onto formers and leave them overnight till they're completely dry. We'll be looking at this later on when we finish it off and assemble the centerpiece for the cake.